Hey you, thank you for joining me today. We are going to talk about a crazy idea I've had, and I have no idea if this is even remotely feasible or possible, but I'm gonna let hopefully a physics or maybe some astrology guy explain to me why what I'm saying to you today is ridiculous. Nevertheless, I thought it was an interesting idea and I'd like to share it with you guys. As you know, every Thursday I talk about an institution or a topic that is so ingrained in society that it would be crazy to challenge it, and that's exactly what I do. The topic that is on the chopping block today is the speed of light. I was thinking, speed of light is annoying, you can't go any faster. If you go faster than the speed of light, you go back in time. What's up with that? Weird. I don't know anything about this. How does that work? And then I thought of something. Well, what if it's actually the speed of light? Because that's the maximum speed at which light can travel. Not because that's its ultimate speed, but it's because it's the speed at which it can maximally travel. And you're going to say, well, Frank, what do you mean? Well, what I mean is that what if the speed of light wasn't the speed of light, but it's the speed of time? So, what would that mean? As we all know, time is basically what is universal and omnipresent, and light is what is that which travels and goes super fast. But what if it's the other way around? What would that imply? That would mean that everything that moves is locked at 300,000 kilometers per second, or 186,000 miles for my American friends, meaning that any object that moves is confined within an envelope that is time. We're just gonna say that this is time, which moves at ridiculous speeds. Light would be pressing against it, but it wouldn't be able to travel any faster because it's caught in time. And that would mean that we cannot really measure the speed of light, because it might go faster, it might be everywhere, always, all the time, which would be weird because it comes from a source. But regardless, so let's say you turn the source on and all of a sudden, boom, light everywhere instantly. So anyway, that would mean that if light pushes against the limits of the speed at which it can travel, because it's captured by time, that is how fast we would see light go. But that isn't necessarily how fast light can go. If the only reason why it's going at that speed is because time goes at that speed. So in this scenario, time would be a concept that is basically created by movement, right? As soon as you move, well, you are limited by time, and time around your movement is created, as if movement were the source of time, as the sun, for example, is a source of light. I don't know if I'm making any sense. I'm super excited about the idea, though, and I still am going to share more, so bear with me. What would that mean in the context of space? Because if time can only travel at what we now know is the speed of light, that would mean that every object within space is limited by this time. What do I mean by that? Well, if an object wants to move, it is limited by that time. So if an object were huge, it cannot move really quickly because it has a maximum movement speed of the speed of time, meaning what we now know as the speed of light. That would mean that everything that is huge, I'm talking huge like galaxy huge, if the Milky Way were an entity wanted to move, he would move really slowly for us because we are in small space-time, comparatively, and so time, whoop, zips by for us. But for something that is huge, that is more than X amount of light years, time for that entity would feel much slower. Or time would pass by much slower. Again, guys, this is not scientific. This is just my idea, and I'm really looking forward to somebody saying,
no, 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 this is completely incorrect, and this is why XYZ.
Bam. But yeah, this just got me all fired up. And I was thinking, what about heat then? Does that maybe travel as fast or faster than the speed of time or the speed of light? Because one of the ideas I also had was that, well, maybe that's where warmth comes from. So what I was thinking was that maybe the light rays of the sun, you know, they try to push against time and they can't. So they are agitated at the edges of where time does not allow them to move. And by that agitation, they create warmth. And I was thinking maybe that is how the Big Bang actually got to be. There was a really slow movement somehow at one point in time. And that movement created time. And within that time, something ignited or exploded because of the friction of all of a sudden there's time into nothingness. So let's not get into the specifics. This is all new for me, probably all new for you, and most likely nonsense. But, so, a really small pocket of time is created. Within that, there is light. That light is so vibrant that it basically fills time up completely until it can't take it anymore and it basically explodes like a bomb. Now then you're gonna ask me, but Frank, where does all the matter come from and stuff? And I'm like, how about you answer me that? And so I was thinking, well, what if that is going to happen on a bigger scale in this universe as well? Meaning time is going to be pressed by light, more and more and more and more and more light, and all of a sudden that will explode. I frankly don't know where I'm going at with this. Especially because, you know what else I thought about? Maybe that explosion of time that was launched way back when was launched at a speed of 300,000 kilometers per second, or 186,000 miles per second, but that was a small explosion. Let's say it was the Big Bang, right? It was a small explosion. But what if that was not the limit of time per se? It was just the limit of time at which the movement was started in our realm. But if we explode, but if everything re-explodes on a bigger scale, maybe then the speed of light could be augmented by a factor of who knows how much more. And I just want to finish with a couple of last points. What if, for example, time, the entity or the thing, time, that has been launched and stretches, I'm imagining, like some kind of super dynamic chewing gum, right? Launched all over. What if the stretch is out and it starts to tear? Or what if there are multiple time dimensions, I'm gonna call them. So there was one explosion in our dimension, and then there was another explosion in another dimension, and they collide and they basically fall on each other. What is that? Anyway, enough with the mumbo jumbo for today. If you liked this video as much as I liked creating it, Let me know in the comments. Like I said, I make videos where I challenge institutions every Thursday, so please have a look at my channel. Feel free to interact as much as you want. I'll make sure to reply. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the future. Bye.